Justice Patterson told this media group on Thursday evening that there were other issues which led to him supporting the appointment of the second highest court candidate over Posaud, who was the top-ranked candidate.
There are issues other than that one, and I don't wish to comment on them, because I don't want to say anything that will hinder Mr. Posaud's career in getting another job over there. My personal, nobody knows that in detail, but it's easy to guess. I feel the choice is the right one.
The BBB commissioners at GCOM recently disclosed that Posaud, an Indo-Guyanese, was bypassed for the DCEO position when the chairman broke a deadlock vote in favor of the second ranker, Roxanne Myers, who is of Afro descent. This action came in light of the recent disclosures made by the BBB officials that candidates applying for posts at GCOM were being rejected and accepted based upon their ethnicity and political alignment as opposed to a process of meritocracy and competence. APNU Commissioner at GCOM Vincent Alexander recently told media operatives that Posaud was not chosen for the position because he has a history of taking and faking his qualifications and a questionable past performance. Yesterday, opposition leader Bart Jagdeo said Posaud may now find it difficult to secure employment because of the hatchet job that has been done to his character. Posaud, who was employed as the PRO at GCOM since 2001, also acted as the DCEO since 2014. However, when his contract expired in that period when there was no chairman at the helm of the Elections Commission, he was informed that he had to reapply for the position. Posaud told this newscast earlier this week that he is now contemplating his next step after his appointment was rejected, a move which he opted not to share his personal thoughts or emotions on. However, he did know that he has always done his work professionally without any racial or political biasness. Michael Young, The Evening News.